With Masada. It came from there, and it looks like the Dead Sea. On the other side there is water, but just in the middle there, going over there, there is just water, and we go a little bigger and up there is water. And going inside. Cinema hall.
Masada is a mountain, but it is also an historic episode that the talented historian and writer Josephus Flavius wrote about almost 2,000 years ago. His account contains all the elements of a fantastic drama in which Jews, Romans, and idealists fight to the death. It's no wonder that Hollywood jumped at the opportunity to tell this fascinating story. With an impressive set and thousands of extras, they created a colossal film featuring the rebel leader Eleazar, son of Yair, and the Roman commander Flavius Silva in the leading roles. However, in the movie, unlike real life, no one really deals with the dilemmas or personal struggles, and certainly not with the more problematic aspects of the story. Then where should we start our story? We could start with the Hasmoneans, who were the first to discover the advantages of this isolated cliff in the heart of the desert. Or we could start at the end, with a dramatic project of the Masada excavations, with Igael Yadin, the head of the excavation team, who would stand on the mountain and read Josephus Flavius' description of the account, and everyone around him could actually hear the echoes of the fighting. Or we could start the quest with King Herod. Herod, who ruled under the auspices of the Romans, built himself a magnificent fortress here on the mountain, which was to be his sanctuary in troubled times. And believe me, he really had troubles. Herod, like any other king, built his palaces to the highest standards of his day. One of them is this Western Palace. Herod's architect was probably a short guy. Here he built himself a bathhouse. And he would put his lamp here and enter his bath. What can I tell you? This king loved the good life. Until now, we spoke about Herod. It wasn't the splendor of Herod's style that made Masada what it is today. The whole affair would be over by morning. But Eleazar had ideas of his own. This is it, the last night. My friends, we've reached the climax of the drama. However, unlike the movie, here apparently the events actually took place. And here at Masada, men with families were forced to decide slavery or death. Eleazar had no doubts, but he had yet to convince his comrades in arms. Ladies and gentlemen, the speech of Eleazar. Oh, my loyal followers, the time has now come that obliges us to make that resolution true in practice. Let our wives die before they are abused, and our children before they have tasted of slavery. And preserve ourselves in freedom as an excellent funeral monument for us, as we have preferred death before slavery. Once Igael Yadin was asked what was the most important artifact he found on Masada. Dozens of priceless objects were found here, he answered. But if I must point to one find, it would be these ostraca. These potsherds. These may be the lots that I'm holding now. Potsherds on which the rebels wrote their names. 10 men who were chosen were the only ones who remained. Their equipment had already burned, and each of them had already killed his wife and children. Then they drew the lots. Who would kill the 9th man and fall on his own sword? And in the morning, the Romans arrived. And besides 2 women and a few children, everyone was dead. After the drama came silence. The silence was broken in the 5th century for nearly 200 years by a community of Byzantine monks. 1,200 years later, the first explorers came and rediscovered the mountain. Then the members of the youth movements, seeking a symbol of Jewish heroism, discovered Masada and adopted the mountain. After them came the hikers and the tourists. Masada had become a focus of pilgrimage. Professor Netzer, what do you really think about the act of courage that ended in suicide?
Maybe it's the utmost courage to prefer death to a life of slavery.
So it's death or freedom?
Yes, death as a free man or slavery in the hands of the Romans. Which choice would you make?
No matter what, Masada has become a symbol of staunch resistance against a fierce enemy. And if it is a symbol, then perhaps this might be some kind of victory. Ladies and gentlemen, I invite you to climb the mountain.
Cable car, and we'll soon be going up.
See if we can see the hikers.
There's a trail up there. On the other side, there's more water. There's less water there, and there'll be more water on the other side where we came from. There goes the cable car to pick others from where we had come from. You see if I can see myself. Guys that are still walking are coming there to the top. So let's go up and explore and see what we can find from the top. Wow, look at that. That's the Dead Sea on the other side. More water. Less water there. And as you go towards this side, you'll find different groups of people here. Going towards very top, and as you can see, there is the Dead Sea, more water on the other side, less water there, and more water on the other side as well, where we have come. But one of the tops of Masada, with the Dead Sea on the other side, a little more water on the other side, less water there, more water that side, and more towards the other side. So it's a huge place. I'm not sure where the top is. People are still going around. It's quite warm here. Thought it was going to be cold, but it's warm.